Assalamu alaikum, dear student. I'm Dr. Sajjad, and today class we will talk about a very important aspect of bacterial identification using 16S ribosomal RNA gene. In this class, we will be comparing two of the most popular databases for this, the EzTaxon, which is also called EzBioClouds, and NCBI database. These two databases are mostly used for bacterial identification. So in this class, we will talk about the differences between these two databases and the recommendation that which database is useful for the bacterial identification. So first of all, let's discuss about the 16S ribosomal RNA gene. We already discussed about this in our previous videos, that how to make a phylogenetic tree and why we use 16S ribosomal RNA gene for bacterial identification. So you can watch those videos for better understanding. Briefly, the 16S ribosomal RNA gene is commonly used in microbiology for identifying bacteria because it's highly conserved in different bacterial species. Small variation within this gene allow us to distinguish between different bacterial species. When you sequence this gene, you need a database to compare it with other bacteria and with other genes, so you can accurately identify your bacterium. So now, what is EzTaxon database? It is also called EzBioCloud database. So specifically, the EzTaxon database is a specialized database that focus only on 16S ribosomal RNA gene sequences for bacterial identification. Now, the important thing in this EzTaxon database, it is curated. It means that expert manually verify your data. When you submit your sequence, so the expert will manually verify your data. So you are getting high quality, reliable sequence when you compare your 16S gene. Ab EzTaxon database mein kya hai? Ke isme jo 16S ribosomal RNA gene aap submit karte ho, usko manually verify kiya jata hai. Ya isme jo already sequences hai, wo already verified hai. Usko manually check kiya gaya hai. इसलिए आइडेंटिफिकेशन में आसानी होगी जब आप बैक्टीरिया अपने बैक्टीरिया को आइडेंटिफाई करना चाहते हो तो ये आपको एक्यूरेट रिजल्ट देगी. EzTaxon डेटाबेस में क्या क्या क्वालिटीज़ है? द फर्स्ट क्वालिटी इट इज क्यूरेटेड डेटाबेस. EzTaxon इज मेंटेन बाय एक्सपर्ट हु कंटिन्यूसली अपडेट द टैक्सोनॉमी टू रिफ्लेक्ट न्यू बैक्टीरियल स्पीशीज. इसमें इस डेटाबेस में स्पेशलिस्ट और एक्सपर्ट होते हैं जो मैन्युअली सीक्वेंसेस को क्यूरेट करते हैं, सीक्वेंसेस को चेक करते हैं. द सेकंड थिंग, कंप्रेहेंसिव रेफरेंस सीक्वेंसेस. इस EzTaxon डेटाबेस में ऑलमोस्ट 60,000 टाइप स्ट्रेन है. टाइप स्ट्रेन मीन कि आप अपने सीक्वेंस को ऐसे बैक्टीरिया के साथ कंपेयर करते हो जो ऑलरेडी पब्लिश है. टाइप स्ट्रेन मीन कि एक बैक्टीरिया है उस पर ऑलरेडी पब्लिकेशन है और वो बैक्टीरिया ऑलरेडी एक टाइप स्ट्रेन बन चुका है. इट मीन वो बैक्टीरिया जीन बैंक जितनी भी जीन बैंक्स है उसमें एक जीन बैंक में भी अवेलेबल है. आप उसको यानी ख़रीद भी सकते हो, आप उसको ऑर्डर भी कर सकते हो अगर आपको अपने एक्सपेरिमेंट में वो चाहिए. तो EzTaxon डेटाबेस है ऑल दोज bacteria which is already published and valid. The third one, EzTaxon database also easy to use, user friendly. Okay, ke isme aap कंपैरिजन आसानी से कर सकते हो. सो इन EzTaxon डेटाबेस टू थिंग्स, द क्यूरेशन एंड द कंप्रिहेंसिव रेफरेंस ट्रेन. दिस इज अ बिग प्लस एज कंपेयर टू NCBI डेटाबेस. And when, especially in that cases, when you are looking for accurate bacterial identification. Now, this is one side, the EzTaxon, and the other side, NCBI. So you all know that NCBI, the National Center of Biotechnology Information, is one of the largest public database out there. It contains a large amount of genetic data, including 16S sequences, but unlike EzTaxon, NCBI is not specialized for 16S alone. So, because in NCBI you can find any data related to sequences, nucleotide sequences, related to protein sequences, but EzTaxon is only designed or only for 16S sequencing. So, NCBI is a multi-purpose database. Now, if we talk about the NCBI database, so in NCBI database, it is a massive data collection. NCBI hold a huge amount of genetic data, which include genomes, protein, and RNA sequences. It is automated data submission in NCBI. And the third thing, that the NCBI BLAST search tool. The NCBI BLAST tool is widely used for sequence alignment, and it is powerful for comparing your 16S sequence to a huge database. Now, this was a comparison of these two databases. So, if we compare the EzTaxon with NCBI, so you can see that if we see the in term of curation, so it EzTaxon takes the lead, and the second term of the specialization, so in that one also EzTaxon will take the lead, because it is specialized database for bacterial identification. Because it is specialized for bacterial identification, so it is highly focused only on 16S RNA sequences, so there will be very less error as compared to NCBI database. Now, the third thing is the quality. The quality of sequences in EzTaxon and NCBI database. In term of number of sequences, NCBI database has larger data set because it accepts public submission from all around the world. However, the quality of these sequences can vary. EzTaxon have fewer sequences overall, but they are of high quality and have been verified by expert. So, NCBI mein jo data hai, wo curated nahi hai. Wo aapko galat bacteria, galat identify kar sakti hai. Kyunki jab bhi hum, agar aap experience karoge, to agar aap ek bacteria ka 16S ribosomal RNA gene aap submit karte ho NCBI mein, to aapko zyadatar species yani bacterial species aegi SP, for example Xanthomonas SP, Bacillus SP, yani uski aap keh sakte ki uski species bhi identified nahi hai. Lekin aapke agar aap tree banaoge, to first mein aapke saath jo alignment hoti hai, local based alignment hoti hai, usme wohi aayenge first list pe. To isliye it will be difficult to make a phylogenetic tree by using the NCBI database. And why it is important? Because sometime when we are submitting a manuscript to a microbiology related journal, so then the reviewer definitely they will ask you that to identify or to make phylogenetic tree by using EzTaxon database. Because in EzTaxon database you have the type strain. Because and when you compare your bacteria with the type strain, so definitely the type strain is already published, so you can compare your genome or your bacteria qualities with that the previously published bacteria as well. So in summary, I will say that EzTaxon is your go-to database. It is if you want to identify your bacteria accurately, so you should use the EzTaxon database. While the NCBI database, you can say it is a large-scale database, and you can use for bacterial identification, but sometime it will not able to give you accurate result, and then you will be you will identify your bacteria wrongly. So now we will go to the database, that how we can use the EzTaxon database. Okay, so you should first of all you should go to the you should open your Google, you can say that Firefox or Google Chrome. So when you open this, you should write here EzTaxon database. Okay, so I will make it larger. So you will see like this EzTaxon. Yeah, it is called EzBioCloud database. So you should click this database. Okay, so when you click database, if you are using for the first time, so you should come here, and then you can log in by your own account. You should create account in this database. Without account, you cannot use this database, and this account creation it is free. And because when you create an account, so your all data will be saved here automatically. So now this is the first page of this EzBioCloud database. What we can do here, you can see here 16 is base ID. Here this one we want to use here for identify bacterial isolate using 16 is sequencing. You can see here this one. This is 16S base MTP, so metagenome community you can do here. This is for COVID-19. This is genome base ID. And this one you can identify your bacteria using 16S and whole genome sequences. And this is, you can say that is shotgun base for also the metagenomic. If you want to identify taxonomic position, taxonomic profiling of metagenomic data, and this is the whole genome analysis of bacteria. So if you have a bacteria and you want a whole genome analysis of that bacteria, you can use this also, this database also for that purpose. But here we will use today 16S ribosomal RNA base ID. So I will click this one. So when you click, it is a note that Google Chrome, because I'm using Firefox, so it's a Google Chrome will be more suitable. So, but it's okay. Now these are the sequences which I already submitted. So we will here you will come and you will click here identify new sequence. So when I click this, so it will open like this. So then I will go my sequence. So here I will copy this sequence. Okay, so when I copy the sequence, I will paste the sequence here. Okay, now I will again give a name to this sequence. You can give this a test one name to this sequence, and then next. Okay, so and then submit. Okay, so now you can see here it is processing your sequence. Okay, now you can see that it is the top hit, it is Enterobacter, I don't know how to pronounce it, Sajjad. This is the bacteria, they say that it is, and this is the strain name, and the similarity is 100%. So now it is the top strain is this one. But if you want more detail, and if you want to make a phylogenetic tree for your by using this EzTaxon, EzCloud, you can click this plus sign. Okay, so when you click the plus sign, so it will give you more data about your alignment and about your comparison, that how your what is the nearest species of your bacteria. Okay, now you can check the result, that this is the full name of my sequence. And the sequence is for 1465 base pair. This is forward orientation and completeness is 100%. And this is the database version, different version are using. So now, this is the first bacteria, okay? My bacteria is related to this one. This is the second one, this one. This is the third one, this one. This is the fourth one. This is the name, the type strand name. So if you click this, you can get more information about the bacteria and about the strain, the species, okay? So now, because these species are already published and already have a lot of data, so then, for example, if you, because it show only 10 sequences, but if you click here, you can increase the number of sequences here. So for example, if I want to use these 25 sequences for my phylogenetic tree, for example, this is the similarity index. You can see here the similarity. Okay, that how much similarity, and this is the accession number. These accession number in different databases from NCBI, from other databases. So this EzTaxon will collect data from different databases. It is not only from one database. It will collect curated sequences from different databases. Now it show the completeness, and this is the taxonomy. Now I want to download this data for to make a phylogenetic tree. So here you can click here this FASTA. Okay, and if you want to click here more information about this, you can click here. This you can click and you can check the database. Okay, by using this. Okay, so I want to download this in FASTA format. So this now you can see here. All the sequences downloaded in FASTA format. Okay. All the sequences. So then you can remove sequences, you can include sequences. Now this file is ready for the alignment. So you can align this file and you can make a phylogenetic tree by using this EzTaxon database. Okay. So in the next slide, in the next class, maybe we will talk about some other databases in the EzTaxon, like how to compare the whole genome databases. Okay. So if you come to the dashboard of this database, so you can see here that how much text size there, how much ribosomal RNA gene, and how much qualified genome and type strain, reference strain, not type strain. So there are many. Okay, so you can, but when you use the tool here, there are multiple tools here. So you can use this ANI calculator, which is the average nucleotide identity calculator, for the comparison between two bacterial genomes. So there are many tools here. So maybe inshallah we will make another video that how to use these tools and how to use this database. So for today, I think this is enough. And if you have any question, so just ask me in the comment section. And because if you have any question related to which database you prefer for bacterial identification, so you can see, you can use both NCBI and you can use both EzTaxon. So, but mostly the reviewer, they like and they will ask for to use those EzTaxon for bacterial identification. So thank you very much. And if you have any question, just let me know in the comment section.